position ng DSWD?
We favor lowering up to 12 for a simple reason, Tito Boy, that we want to protect these children.
Okay.
Because children in conflict with law, we categorize this as also victims themselves.
Okay.
So we are for lowering age of criminal, social responsibility to 12.
Doc, ikaw?
Maganda nga naman sinasabi nila, yung reform, yung system. Pero yung 1930, yung sinasabi niyang batas, at that time siguro, ang mga tao, hindi nga kagaya nga ngayon. Pero para sa akin, ang kailangan lang talaga natin, yung mga bata mapangalagaan. Gusto ng gobyerno, gusto ng batas, pangalagaan sila. Pero a child that is most of the time institutionalized, hindi din nakakabuti. Kasi yung attachment issue niya, wala siyang grounding. Anong grounding niya? Institution. So a child that is prolonged sa isang institution, hindi din healthy. Kaya maganda
Doc,
community.
Doc, sandali lamang. Pero between an institution and the streets, halimbawa,
correct.
Or between the institution and yung factory kung saan may child labor, di ba, it's choice between
lesser evil.
Hell and okay. The deep blue sea.
Kaya diba? Nga nabanggit ko, maganda ang programa nila if yung bata matuturuan, marireform. Kasi kung yung bata na-reform, nabigyan ng proper intervention, gaya na nabanggit nga, yung bata na yun, kung kaya na niyang tumayo at the age of 18, 19, 20, kaya na niya tumayo with conviction what is right and what is wrong.
No, I think we're talking about restorative justice here, mm-hmm. Diba? We're talking about reforming
yes.
The child. I think the law is sensitive to this, right?
Yes, oo.
Yung dahilan kung bakit nagkaroon ng Juvenile Justice and Welfare Act,
and Welfare Act
is to reform. Mm-hmm. The problem is, hindi nila ito ma-enforce ng mabuti. Dahil ang daming mga issues na wala, kulang. Kaya tuloy, sabi nga natin, yung 15 years old na nagiging exempted from criminal liability, mm-mm. Sabi nga natin, sabi mo, Usec, nagdadala na lang ng birth certificate, o ito, hindi ako pwede ikulong kasi 15 years old ako. Mm-hmm. Alam na
syndicate.
Nila.
It will take a village, mm-hmm. A whole country, mm-hmm. To effect change.
Yes. Yes.
Hindi pwedeng sigaw lang ng sigaw sila, Aimee. Yes. And we just watch them, or the lawyers, or the doctors. Kailangan the whole community, di ba?
As one.
Moves, the whole community moves as one, as a family.
Kaya nga sabi nga nila, di ba, no man is an island.
Correct.
So kanina sa dressing room, when I met Aimee, the first thing I said, I want to listen. Mm-hmm. I don't want to say no, I don't want to say yes, mm-hmm. I want to listen. What is it there? Because, you know, ignorance does not excuse me from the law. And, you know, as you teach me, as you let me understand, like si attorney, 1930, like si Aimee, sinabi niya may mga programa. I even ask her, how possible are this program going to be implemented? How possible? Paano? How can they have access? And it was a very nice conversation. And sana din, everyone who would say yes or a no before you say yes or a no, pakinggan, panoorin ito.
Ganda ng attitude po na yan. Oo, yung,
and I appreciate it.
Ako din.
Maging proactive tayo.
Tama. At maging bukas.
Yes.
At huwag ipaubaya. Palagay ko ang importante, lalo na sa mga magulang, huwag ipagsapalaran at ipaubaya ang pagiging magulang sa iba.
Of course.
May attitude na ganun na dapat binabasag din natin na stakeholder ka sa pagpapalaki ng bata.
Correct.
Attorney Claire.
Yes, sa akin siguro talagang dapat una rito magulang. I-guide nila yung anak nila. Yung about sex education, dapat sa ganitong age, i-explain nila ano yung tama at mali. Sa school din, dapat binibigyan nila ng pansin. Sabi nga natin, not more on academics, but more on, paano ba ikaw kumilos? How to determine what is good and what is bad? So, ito mga scenario nito. Even the parents, sabi nga natin, ang parents, they should be aware kung ano ba ang consequence ito. Even the schools, dapat alam nila to para sila yung may responsibilidad sa bata.
Aimee?
On the part of the government, we have to intervene because this is a form of abuse. Now, we have to identify what is the proximate cause of this one. And after identifying the proximate cause, why children are doing these things, then we have to come up with a concrete plan of action. The concrete intervention, the efficient and effective intervention, and to put that into action.
We have a choice. We have a choice to just sit down and enjoy it or and complain or say this is not good, or we have a choice to stand up and do our little part in helping ourselves first, helping our family, and helping our community. A little help, a little light will always shine the darkest room.
Maraming salamat. Thank you. Ang dami kong learnings. Susugang ko lamang yun. Let's take care of our children, because by taking care of our children, we're taking care of families.
Yes.
We're taking care of communities and we're taking care of our country. We talk about a better world. We talk about better jobs. Let's start with our children. Not tomorrow, but now.